10-year note treasury yields open the session higher, pressing close to that 75 basis point barrier. That will be the outer end of the 55 to 75 basis point range. We didn't get there. We pulled back. We saw buyers stepping up midway through the session into the afternoon. A lot of that had to do with the month-end extensions, the largest in 10 years. Yes, a lot of that was probably occurred late last week. We saw the rally. However, there's some residual buying left to do. I think that's really what took us off those lows and those high yields, pushing prices higher and yields lower as we went into the close. So right now, hovering around 70 basis points, well off those extremes. And at this point, a lot of that has to do with the month-end extensions that we talked about, buyers coming in to balance their books. Market volatility, well, last week we went out on the highs, and this week we open up on the lows. So we did see vols kind of hold steady on the open as yields were higher, but as buyers came in and pushed us back towards the middle of the range, that 55 to 75 basis point range, we did see volatility come off quite spectacularly. In the front month, we saw it as levels we haven't seen in over a month. In the back months, yes, they were lower. They weren't as aggressively lower, but certainly lower than you would expect, given the fact that we still have a lot of information coming out this week and those November elections are still looming. But again, volatility down across the board as we trade back towards the midpoint of the range. And lastly, what do we have the rest of this week? It's all about jobs. So we've got the ADP number coming out on Wednesday, the claims number on Thursday, and the non-farm payroll number on Friday. And all are important, but I think that claims number stands out as the in-the-moment number. Where am I now? And that is the one that's been telling the story. Claims remain above a million. We've seen one mark below a million since the beginning of the pandemic. We need to see more of those. We need to see a gradually decline in those claims. Certainly, that would be one sign that the economy is recovering. We have not seen that yet, so that'll be something we're watching very closely. Certainly, we'll watch the non-farm payroll number as well. The non-farm payroll number has not been a problem. It's been very strong since we bottomed out early in the pandemic. So at this point, it becomes all about the jobs this week. We get three pieces of data. Obviously, all are important. We'll be watching all the bond market. However, though, has been leaning towards higher yields. Except for the aforementioned month-end buying, likely will test those high yields again. But can they hold it? Jobs numbers will tell the tale of the tape.